Hey y'all, Surfing Supple here, long time no see. Today is July 26, 2017. I got a new product in. I'm gonna put it together, assemble it. I'm not gonna unbox it because the box it came in was pretty much messed up. But the product is built so well, it made it through FedEx from Arizona to Texas by the grace of God. Know how it's called the Joy Charcoal Stove. Check it out. Let me tell you, you saw my Tao cooker. Well, I used the heck out of that thing and it cracked. Cracks all over it inside, the clay's falling apart. I recommended it one time to those of you that I recommended it. Hopefully it won't happen to you, but it happened to me. So I had to go out and start shopping around. I got the Tao cooker for about 80 bucks. Well, this thing was 120, $40 more. No clay, no rusting parts, puro aluminum. I live on the coast, aluminum's my friend. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, we got our, I wanna call it, it's kinda like a Tao cooker. It's called the Joy Charcoal Stove. Made in Philippines, so it is oriental. It's got a patent apparently right here, which is cool. But this is all one piece. Actually, not one piece. This is a separate piece. This is separate. And this is riveted on the bottom. But this is all cast aluminum. Pretty stoked on it already. Let's just go ahead and start putting the parts together, okay? First thing when it comes, the only assembly you have to do is put this little screw on. You see it? Right there. So I have it on there. I'm going to take some Loctite. I actually bought another nut. It only had one. I bought another one. Put a little bit of Loctite. Then I'm going to tighten it down. Just tighten it against another. Bought another nut. Two nuts on one on each side. Tighten it down, hand tight. There, we're good. Now what this is an ashtray. Not like that guy in that movie, ashtray. This is a real ashtray, okay? Now, I can't even see what's going on. Hopefully you can see this. This slides on the bottom here. See? When the ashes fall, you can pull them out. All right, we got our ashtray in. Next. This is a kind of like a fire ring, I guess, the firebox, part of the firebox, and it has vents, but it has also a handle. So again, we're gonna put a drop of Loctite. There we go, just a drop. And we're gonna tighten it. Hand tighten, big deal. Now this, you slide in right here. And it's going to come out in the front right here. Let's just do it this way. Okay. Now what this is, you can slide it. See? Shut. Open. Shut. Open. All the way around you have these vents. Let me show you. Shut. Open. Shut. Open. Back. Shut. Open. Whoop. Wrong one. Shut. Open. All right. You get the point. Getting a little bit carried away. Next stop, this is metal, this is iron, okay? So one part of it is iron. That just sits in here as such. And I think, there. The reason is that the coals are gonna lay on this, okay? Now, you got a fire ring here. If you wanna use it to keep the heat away from the sides and straight up the middle, you can. The reason being, is it has this. This is the top. And what this is, it has various pieces. You take one out. If you have a small pot, you lay it there. The heat will only come out here. A little bit larger pot, or say a little tiny wok, you set it here. It'll balance on these raised areas. If you want to get a little bit bigger wok, or you want to, yeah, I guess that'd be for a bigger wok. You take another one off, and so on and so forth, until you get to the very end and this is all you have. I forgot one part. It comes with a grill. Anyway, I'll get that. We're going to cook a steak, by the way. But we're not going to put this. We're taking this out. All right. It has a handle to lift it up and down right here. See? Nice handle. Now let's get to these. These shut. They're handles also, but you don't touch it while it's being cooking. But you can pick it up like this while it's still cold. But let's say we are cooking and our coals are running down. Well, on both sides, open it up, drop the coals in, shut it. Isn't that cool? And there's one on this side, same thing. Open it up, drop a couple coals in, shut it. So that's it. This is the Joy charcoal stove. And I'm pretty stoked on it already. So let me get some steaks. Or actually, we're going to demonstrate firing it up, but I got to find a good place, not here on the table. Be right back, folks. Okay, we're going to take one of these fire starters from Royal Oak. We're going to set that right here in the middle, okay? Then we're going to take some, I don't know if you can see that, B&B charcoal, oak. We're going to lay them around the fire starter as such. No lighter fluid. We don't believe in that down here. Greg Rempe does. And those guys. I don't know how hot to make this, but I'm gonna go pretty hot. Heck with it. Gotta test it out eventually, folks. Let's just go with that, okay? Alright. Come on. Can't really. Oh boy, it's always something, folks. Come on. Pain in the butt. There we go. I gotta throw that thing away. All right. I'm going to start it like this, like that. Let's just go with that, okay? So we're going to let that get going. And here's the grate I was telling you about that fits perfectly on here. So we'll let this get going, then we'll go get our steaks and we'll grill some steaks. Our fire's up to temp now. Let's lay on some boneless ribeyes from Staple Street Meat Market. Put one right here. Very hot. Very, very hot. Let's see what we get, folks. I don't know what to expect, but it does look like it's a good fire for steaks. And I don't really want this right there. Let's get it out of there. Put it over here away from that piece of mesquite. There. Whoa. There we go. I sprayed the grate down with grilling spray, but since then it probably came off. Now this grate is made out of metal. It's gonna eventually rust. So I might have to take the dimensions and have one of my buddies make me a stainless steel grate that'll fit on there. And in fact, the one from the Kamado that I've been using on the Tao Cooker might actually fit. We don't know yet. Let's see what we got. Sticking for sure. It's a hot, hot fire, folks. Hot, hot. They say these are thin steaks, but they're actually fatter than most steaks you'll find at a grocery store. These were, I believe, $5.99 a pound. When you start getting fire in the hole, then just flip it. There we go. We're grilling now, folks. Look at that. And Tim Dickey says, the more searing, the more flavor. And we'll get a shout out to Mike Meehan of Staple Street Meat Market. What's up, Mike? We'll let these go for a couple more minutes, folks. Now these grill marks are very thin, unlike grill grates. But this is a nice little gadget, to tell you the truth. And I'll test fajitas on it too. Just keep flipping it. There you go, look at that. It's what you want to see. You want to see the meat bubbling, but not burning. Bubbling like that. Seems to be hotter over there. That's about the same. Like everything else, it probably has a hot area and then a cool area. Cool, like as in not as hot. Keep doing this. How many flips, Sapo? How many times? What temperature? I don't know. I'm just cooking, folks. I'm guessing. If I was to say, I'd say maybe 8 minutes max on these steaks. I set them out till they were a little bit cooler than room temperature. So when you see it start catching, just flip it. It won't want to actually burn the meat. I'm shooting for about medium rare. Not quite a crust on there. Okay, I think I'm gonna go with that. We'll take them in and rest and we'll do the taste test, folks. I decided to test fajitas too. These are just Staple Street regular skirt steaks, not the Angus. And I marinated them, papaya, a little bit of rice vinegar, a little bit of lemon juice, some fajita seasoning, and garlic. And that's it. So let's see what we got. You see some of the papaya on there. I didn't wash it off. It's okay. Not gonna hurt nothing. I only marinated it for probably an hour. I wanted to go longer, but since the coals were nice and hot, I decided to wait. And boy, are they hot. Got a hot, hot, hot fire. But this is really what I bought it for. We love to make fajitas at the beach on Saturdays. Me and Faye and David Garcia and his wife, and whoever else joins us. We like to make fajitas, and then we go ahead and make some tacos and take a break around 11 to 12 while we're fishing and eat, and then we hit the surf hard again for a second go around. So you'll be seeing more of this in videos soon. for the sake of time, I'm going to cut this short, but we'll take a look at the fajitas at the end. Here's our steak. It's all rested. Let's just cut into it. This is an old knife. It's good. If you look, it's nice and pink inside, you see? Let's see if I can get it to focus. Nice and pink. Came out good. Let me put this to the side and grab a piece of fajita so you can see what it looks like. This, I tasted already and it came out insane. Now the reason I put them on like little pieces so we could just throw it right in a tortilla. But I'm gonna cut it long ways like we always do. Show you what it looks like. Hold on. Patience, my friend. There you go. Nice skirt steak from Staple Street Meat Market. This is awesome. This is awesome, but that mango that I use, I said papaya, I think, earlier, but it's mango in the marinade. I'll put a link to the marinade page, or I'll just put it in the description how to make it. It's real easy. This just salt and pepper, but this had the marinade, and I'm going to marinate some to take to the beach to eat while we're fishing. So, all right, well, let's do our usual taste test, okay? Let's start off by tasting the steak. Staple Street Meat Market, boneless ribeye, $5.99 each. Delicious. Medium rare. Perfect. Just melts in your mouth, folks. That's probably fork tender. That really does hit the spot. Now for the fajitas. Marinated. Oh, man. Y'all got to try this marinade. This is like, wow. All those flavors merged together. I think it was some restaurant that uses this and they gave away the recipe and I borrowed it. I hate to say it. I don't hate to say it, but I'm going to say it. The fajitas taste better than the steak. I might marinate a steak in that stuff next time. This is really, really, really good. All right, I'll go crazy if I keep eating. Anyhow, thanks for watching. Sorry it took so long for another video. It's every day 97 to 100 degrees. And I work in the heat, so when I get home, I just want to chill out inside the house. You can understand that, I hope. And the heat index, it's 110 degrees outside. So I've been staying in and eating different kind of stuff that you don't cook out back. But for you good folks today, I ordered that grill and it came in yesterday. And I decided to do a assembly video and my first cook on it. So I hope you enjoyed it. This thing's made in the Netherlands. But the thing is that you buy it at a place in Arizona and then he ships it to you and it takes about 3 to 5 days to get here. It came in okay. The box was crushed, but nothing was broken. It's all metal, like I said, so that's going to last. By what I see, that's going to last a while. It would take some kind of mishap or some kind of freak accident to destroy it. All right, folks. Well, thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Give me a thumbs up. Leave some comments. And if you want to come down here to Corpus Christi, Texas, let me know in advance and I'll meet you on a weekend. We'll go to the beach and we'll make some fajitas and relax, okay? We'll fellowship. You're more than welcome down here, okay? All right, y'all. That's it for now. God bless you. And like I always say, goodbye. Adios, amigos.